Hey everyone, Vinayak here. I had made a video earlier on how to back up your photos to your hard drive without using a laptop. It worked well, but it was a bit finicky in usage as the OTG reader could easily unplug itself, causing everything to disconnect, which is not a great solution. In my last video, I had integrated the Raspberry Pi with a 5-inch touchscreen. Let's use this one to make a more robust solution.
I was looking around for a memory card backup solution, and there is a moderate selection available. But their prices are jaw-dropping. The best of the lot, I guess, is the Narbox, which I really liked. But starting at $499 for the 256GB model, it's not affordable for someone like me. As I have a Raspberry Pi lying around, it now having a touchscreen with the 4 integrated USB ports could act as a backing up device. I'm using the same 500GB Samsung T5 SSD in this project. And one change would be that I'm using a card reader instead of an OTG adapter. I have a video on how to integrate a 5-inch display with the Raspberry Pi here. The device is nice and snug within its 3D printed case. Now for the code. This is a fork from Just a Hobby's Git, as he had written the code for a 3.5-inch screen. I wanted to convert it for a 5-inch screen, else the UI would look too small. So without having to reinvent the wheel, this was about 90% of what I needed the functionality to be. If you want to see the original source, you can find it here. Let's clone the code from my repository. Git clone https://github.com/thevinayaknair/pycopy.git. This will copy the code onto your Raspberry Pi. Now enter the directory cd pycopy ls to see all the files present there. You can see the .py file in the directory. This is the code which will handle the copying of the data between the connected USB drives. You will notice that there are two .py files, filecopy.py and filecopyfy.py. The PyCopy.py is for the 3.5-inch screens and PyCopy5 is for 5-inch touchscreens. We will now need to install the Python tkinter GUI library. This will allow us to display GUI elements on screen. To install tkinter, type in sudo apt-get install python tk. SH is a unique subprocess wrapper that maps your system programs to Python functions dynamically. So SH will help you write shell scripts in Python. So install SH using the command sudo pip install sh. As our drives are generally formatted in Windows, we will need the xfatutils to be able to mount the drives. Install the xfatutils using the command sudo apt-get install xfatfuse xfat-utils. All these commands are available in the description and on our website, so you can check it out there. Let's place a shortcut on the desktop to easily access the Pi script when required. Cd desktop sudo nano pycopy.desktop, and these are the entries that you have to make within. I already have a desktop file within the Git, so you could copy that directly to your desktop and change the paths accordingly. If you are using a 3.5-inch screen, use pycopy.py. As I have a 5-inch touchscreen, I'm using pycopyfy.py. Now we are ready to test the code. Plug in a drive, can be source or destination, no specific order. After that, plug in the second drive. On the desktop, run the Python script and we have the interface displayed. Select the source drive in column 1 and destination drive in column 2. Confirm the selection, confirm again, and the copying process begins. And we are done. Just fantastic. Let's check if the content has been really copied. Here we have a folder on the SSD with a date and time. This is just great. And I powered all the devices with this tiny power bank, which makes this a portable solution. You can also use a power adapter instead if you don't want to power the device via a power bank. Another advantage is that we can use any type of card reader, effectively future-proofing this as a backup device. So I can use XQD cards or any other card reader and it still works. USB 2.0 will not provide the fastest transfer rates, but it still works, which is what we would want on the field.
So this is my variation of the PyCopy code, which I did get the initial source code online, just cleaned it up a little and added a 5-inch version too. If you're using a 5-inch screen, you can use that. Hope you like this video, and you can always message me at techatalkingstuff.net if you want to ask me any questions, or you can WhatsApp me at 965257833. Also, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to be notified when new videos are added. Thank you for watching, and see you all next time.